the second half of the American Music Awards, honoring the most distinguished American vocalists, groups, single recordings, and albums from the fields of pop, rock, soul, country, and disco music. Your hosts for the 6th Annual American Music Awards are Glenn Campbell, Helen Reddy, and Donna Summer. And now, here is Glenn Campbell.
Well, all right. Thank you. You know, well, you're more than generous. Every year, the American Music Award of Merit is presented to someone who has made outstanding contributions to America culture by way of music. The Award of Merit has been received by such distinguished individuals as Bing Crosby, Berry Gordy Jr., Irving Berlin, Johnny Cash, and last year's recipient, the fabulous Miss Ella Fitzgerald. She's a guest. To tell us about this year's winner is a young lady whose first solo effort won an American Music Award last year. She's now part of the pop, whatever that word is. Ladies and gentlemen, she's just a fabulous singer, Miss Debby Boone.
The recipient of the 1979 American Music Award of Merit is a very special part of the American fabric, and someone very special to me in particular, because he's my honorary godfather. When I think of him, I think of family, but then so does the rest of America. He's a musical giant, but a gentle giant. He's Mr. C, Mr. Perry Como. The love affair between Perry Como and the television camera began in 1949, and it continues to this day.
The song that I've been waiting to hear.
Dream along with me. I'm on my way to the stars.
I should worry, I should care, I shouldn't be a millionaire.
Hello, young lovers, whoever you are, the one I love belongs to somebody else. Shadow of your smile. When you are gone, I love you.
That's the song of songs, temptation.
Older, only better. That's not only my opinion. American women voted for Perry Como as the ideal husband of the year in 1956. And they were right, because this year marks the 46th anniversary of his marriage to Roselle Bellini Como.
Letters, we get letters, we get stacks and stacks of letters.
And boy, did they get letters. Here's a very special delivery that just arrived from Mr. Bob Hope.
Dear Perry, my goodness, it's awful nice to be here to honor you, the Neapolitan Nembutal. You know, Perry's parents came over here from the old country, but he still has the jet lag. Now, let me tell you, Perry's voice is as smooth as ever. Of course, yours would be smooth, too, if every morning you gargled with marinara sauce. Now, let me tell you, trying to keep Perry awake for an hour is like trying to get Dolly Parton into a T-shirt.
I mean, you know me, one mood.
Come on, you're on, you're on. I know it, I'm right in the middle of my opening number.
Anyway, but seriously, Perry, you've entertained generations of Americans, not only with your music, but with your warmth and friendship and your scissors. So, after you pick up the award, will you stop in my dressing room? I'd like a little off the side, if you don't mind, huh?
He may have started out as the barber of Cannonsburg, Pennsylvania, but with 18 gold records to his credit, not even the barber of Seville can match his achievements. By 1959, Perry Como's record sold more than 50 million copies. His most recent gold record was in 1978 for And I Love You So.
Break your heart, hot diggity dog, ziggity boom, what you do to me?
Find a wheel and it goes round, round, round. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Dream along with me. Live without your love is just impossible.
Earlier this week, we took our cameras to Las Vegas, where we met with one of Perry's most popular guests. She appeared on his show more than any other performer. Ladies and gentlemen, from her dressing room at the Desert Inn, the one and only Miss Lena Horne.
Dear Mr. Como, we've appeared together so many times on so many of your shows, and it's always made me happy to be invited to appear with you. Even tonight when I'm made up to go on stage and not properly made up for television. But the reason is simple. Singing with you anytime is almost the most fun a woman can have.
Everybody knows as Barney Miller crossed paths with Mr. Como in early stages of his career. And here he is to tell us about it, Mr. Hal Linden.
Dear Mr. C, this may not be common knowledge, but my television career began on your show. I was in the chorus of the Ray Charles Singers, your vocal backup group. Yes, nowadays it's three girls and a lot of microphones. In those days, it was about 24 people going, ooh-wah. Well, I didn't last very long, but that was okay. It was because I had auditioned for my very first Broadway show opposite Judy Holliday in Bells Are Ringing. I got the part, and you were very encouraging to me. You've always been a big influence on me and just about every singer of my generation, and I just came by tonight to say thank you.
To present the 1979 American Music Award of Merit is last year's recipient of this honor. Ladies and gentlemen, a living legend, Miss Ella Fitzgerald.
Anymore. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. One of the greatest thrills that happened to me last year was to win the American Music Award, I'm so nervous I can't read it, of merit. And it gives me a great pleasure to present this year's recipient, the great Mr. Perry Como.
Congratulations. I want to read the inscription that's on here. I'm going to block you for a second. It says, The American Music Award of Special Merit to Perry Como. Through his music, he has brought the best of America to the world. His talent, his warmth, his integrity, and his longevity has enriched the lives of us all.
Thank you, Debbie, and thank you, Ella.
Nobody no greater than me, but we deserve it. So many years.
Excuse me.
Thank you, love. Grazie.
Well, good night. I thought you were going to bury me out here. Sounds like a eulogy, but it was wonderful. This is quite an honor for me. I don't want to make light of the fact that it is a beautiful award, and I appreciate it very much. She says, longevity. Does that mean old?
Whatever you say.
I have been around for quite a few years, and I have a lot of people to thank for my being around. In fact, I've been around so long, and it's kind of nice to be acknowledged by your peers. When I recorded my first song for RCA, there were fingerprints on it from Thomas Edison. Well, this is yours. You notice I don't have any cue cards, and you know this is kind of a sad spot for me, because me being one of the all-time great ad-libbers, you know, I don't need cue cards. You know that if you've watched our shows. After I say good evening, that's about it. I'm Orson Hope. But I don't need cue cards for what I have to say. I'd like to thank a few people who have made it possible for me to stay around for about 40 or 50 years. I want to go back about 15 years to our first television shows. I think they were on for Kraft. Will that be cut out? No. But I had some very bright people on that show. For an example, we had Nick Vanoff, who was a producer. We had Dwight Hemian, who was a director. We had Gary Smith, who was the scenic designer. And to top it all off, we had the daddy of all writers, Goodman Ace. It was a real delight, and of course, with these kind of people, your job becomes very simple, even for 40 years. But I did have a lot of fun, especially with Dwight. Dwight Hemian, I know that you've seen his name and Gary's and Nick Vanoff's on plenty of crawls. That's the thing you see on television shows, you know. They're wonderful. I think they're the finest television people in the world. I can say that because I have the bills to prove it. You know, Dwight was never happy, and I kind of like that in him, because he was never happy with a shot coming up, you know, like that, Debbie. You remember the shows. He had the greatest eyeball shots and ear shots, nostril shots. And I say, Dwight, come on, you know. The money is going right down the sewer, you know. He said, don't worry about it. But I appreciate that about him. We did that for about 10 years, and I had a lot of fun, a lot of experience, so I'd like to thank them. And later on, of course, we went into doing what we call television specials, where I was directed, and very capably, by Bob Banner and his group. I think Bob is here somewhere tonight. And we did shows from different parts of the country. I might add, we did shows from all over the world, which I got a big kick out of. And according to the numbers we got for the shows, you folks also got a kick out of it. So I want to thank Bob and his group, and two people who I couldn't do a show without, nor would I want to do a show without them. They're here, too. Nick Perito and Ray Charles. That's about all I have to say, and I just want you to know that I'm very thrilled with this award, and I know there's a very lovely lady somewhere in Florida with a big grin on her face, and but she don't get these kind of things. So when I get home, I'm going to split it with her.